everyone. So in the session number 6, we have seen about the instrumentation of the flame photometry. In session number 7, we will be seeing about the applications of flame photometry. So talking about the qualitative applications, what are the qualitative applications? The flame photometric methods are widely used for the determination of alkali and the alkaline earth metals in samples that are easily prepared as aqueous solutions. Some of these elements can be detected visually by the color in the flame. Example, sodium produces yellow flame. However, this method is not very reliable. The best method is to use flame photometer with a filter or monochromator to separate radiations with the wavelength characteristics of the different metals from other radiation present. If the radiation of the characteristic wavelength is detected, it will indicate the presence of the metal in the sample. The method to carry out detection of elements by flame photometry is fast, simple, and is carried out with care quite reliably. However, there are some difficulties. It does not provide information about the molecular structure of the compound present in the sample solution. Non-radiating elements such as carbon, hydrogen, and halides cannot be detected. These can only be determined under special circumstances. Quantitative applications. Flame photometry was developed by Lindegaard to determine the concentration of various soil components. The concentration of various alkali and alkaline earth metals is important in determining the suitability of the soil for cultivation. Very often, an analysis of shed leaves of the plants of calcium and potassium is carried out. This gives a general idea of the concentration of these ions in the soil, which can be taken up by the plant. For agricultural purposes, an analysis of the proper mixture of surface soil and subsoil is carried out to determine the fertilizer requirements of the soil. In all these analyses, the soil or the ash is evaporated to dryness with concentrated hydrochloric acid, and the residue is treated with water or dilute HCl to get these ions into aqueous solutions. In clinical chemistry, it is very important to determine the concentration of sodium and potassium ions in the body fluid, since their ratio controls the actions of muscles, including the heart. Since these ions form few insoluble compounds and exhibit essentially no acidic or basic properties, they cannot be determined readily by conventional wet chemical techniques and are usually measured instrumentally. Flame photometry is the usual technique employed in determining these ions. This is achieved by diluting the blood serum and aspiration into the flame. Now, application of flame photometer in various industries. So, flame photometer can be used in pharmaceutical industry, beverage, food, environmental analysis, chemical industry, and cement industry. In pharmaceutical industry, flame photometry can be utilized for determining the concentration of sodium and potassium ions in infusion solutions such as NaCl solution, Ringer solution, or others. Product control and indirectly quality testing of various substances over sodium, potassium, or lithium. Concentration determination in pharmaceutical reagents. In beverage industry, determination of the contents of sodium, potassium, and calcium in various liquids such as fruit juices, vegetable juices, and soft drinks. In food industry, monitoring compliance with sodium and potassium limits in foods. In the production of pre-milk, pre-food, and milk powder, the quality can be controlled and monitored with a flame photometer. In environmental analysis, laboratory measurements for the determination of alkali and alkaline earth elements. In chemical industry, for final inspection of inbound inspection of chemical products. Whereas in cement industry, it is utilized for review of sodium, potassium, or calcium content in the construction of and cement industries. Analytical methods. Classic flame photometry is a method for the determination of the elements by direct measurement of one of its spectral emission lines in a flame, that is particular use of sodium, potassium, magnesium, manganese, copper. These are, however, a number of indirect methods which are used for particular interest for the analysis. That's all for this session. Thank you.